Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. We're continuing on the project of electrifying our backyard pavilion. We got the cable pulled yesterday and that was enough for one day. Today I'm going to work on continuing attaching the cable at the house and to the pavilion itself. Oh, and the theme of today is chainsaws and barking dogs. I dug some of the dirt out and got this back up. I glued in this offset. I've attached a piece of 5/4 pressure treated, installed a box. I will probably cut these conductors off here and we'll switch to smaller wire and then go up the post and go on that side. I've laid a pull elbow up there and that is what is going to turn the corner and go inside. So I have pre-cut a piece of conduit and I have pre-cut some spacers that will screw on and clamp the conduit to. The reason I'm offsetting it is to clear that offset up there and don't have some, have to put some goofy fitting in there to make that happen. I'm gonna go ahead and pre-drill. I'll put the start the first one right here. I'm gonna pre-drill it so it doesn't split. The screws from the clamps will hold it also, so I'm just putting this in just to hold it. Good idea to make sure it's level too. Come on. There we go. I got my piece pre-cut and I have glue here somewhere. Make sure to make a huge mess with that. Yeah, that was way too much glue. I put glue inside the fitting. And there we go. And that's a splinter in my hand right there. These clamps that we will clamp to that little spacer block. Based on previous experience, I'm going to pre-drill. There's that. I will run the cable. I probably won't use a box. I'll just put a coupling and run another piece of pipe up and run it in the other side. I think next we'll go to the house side and work on that. So we're up here at the house end. I got these pipes secured with a piece of blocking at the bottom and I'm going to come up and you can finally buy 90 degree elbows in this town again. So I'm going to 90 degree it up at the top and take it back towards the house. I don't know how much I'm going to be able to film the crawl space and under the deck, but I'm going to feed it through the pieces that I put in there while I, instead of trying to run the pipe and then pull it, I'll just feed the wire through and then glue it. I don't know how well this will show up under the deck. There's the wire conduit stubbed up. We're gonna run across and go through the house. I'm gonna bend it up some and go right above that foundation vent. That way I'm not going through brick. Should just be wood, I hope. We'll see. So we're gonna penetrate the house right up here.
and I don't know what my thought process was, but the brick facade runs up behind this ledger for the deck. This brick facade runs up obviously behind this. If I went through lower, I'd be going through the concrete block foundation also. So in theory, up here, all I need to go through is the brick. So I'm going to use a hammer drill and try to get through that. Through the final layer of wood, use this long aircraft drill bit to try to get all the way through that, and that'll locate us inside. Then we can go in the crawl space and finish the hole coming out this way. So it's the next day, and I've gotten as through far through that as I can possibly get. So I knew I was going to switch over to Romex anyway. I've stubbed this Romex out through the wall. I'm going to take a short piece of the conduit and shove it inside there, and that will protect the wire, and it'll go pretty far into this wall. I cannot get a straight shot all the way through, and I didn't want to go spend the $100 for an inch and eighth masonry bit. So that's as far as that's going to go. That'll protect it. And then got a round junction box. I will glue that on, get our other conduit into this end, and then run a piece of 2x4 support across here to support the box. I'll make my joints in the box and face it, I guess, upside down. It's a gasketed box anyway, so it won't get any water in it. I don't know how much of this you're going to be able to see.
It's like we have a dog helping too. Cooper, what are you doing?
All the knockouts in this box are closed, so I knocked out the opposite two. Right now, I'll just run it straight through.
So, somehow I didn't have any pressure-treated 2x4s around. So I had to go purchase one at Lowe's. And this thing was like $7. And this was one of the best ones in the whole bundle. I mean, I'm not going to see this. It's going to be under the deck. But still, that shouldn't be first quality, especially for that price. Seems like a couple months ago, this would have been like $4. So I don't know if my lapel mic was dead when I did the under the deck part, but under the deck I pulled the wires in, finished the conduit, stripped them back, and I tied one of the black wires to the ground wire. So they're tied together in the box under the deck so I can identify which one's which, because I neglected to tape them when I put them in. So should get continuity. We can turn it to make noise too. Come on. So we hear the beep, we know which we're on the wire. See if I tie it to the other wire. We're just checking resistance. So it's obviously not that one. So this is the wire that is hooked to the ground under the deck. So we're making a circuit back to the box under the deck, back to here. So we'll make this our neutral wire. We'll identify that by taping this wire white. Now we'll go back under the deck and the wire that's hooked up to the neutral, I have a wire nut on there, we'll tape that up and then we'll know which one's which and we can make our connections under the deck.
So we're back under the deck. I'm hoping for the last time, at least with the electrical, put a wire nut on the ground wire between the two. So now we just need to connect the white from the Romex going into the house to the one I've taped white, and then the two blacks will go together. I can tuck this pull string back in, and there's a cover to go on this, and then we should be done with the electrical under here. This might be the biggest set of wire nuts I've ever seen. They're rated for 6 to 14 stranded wire. Tuck them back in that box and shove the pull string in there and put the cover on. Likely won't ever need this pull wire. Like many wires are going to fit in that conduit anyway. Many more, but rather have it than not. There's a gasket and screws. Out of here. So today we're back out here. It's been a few weeks and it's leaf blowing season. So there are leaves underfoot and everybody is blowing them. So hopefully, normally it doesn't show up as bad as I think it's going to on camera on the microphone. So I'm going to run conduit from over there where we come up across. I'm going to take that box and install it up above, so if at some point we want to come out of there and do a ceiling fan or do some other things in the ceiling, we have a way to get out of the conduit. I'm going to bring the conduit over and install this box up here and install some outlets for TV, cable box, etc. And then bring that conduit down here where I've already installed this box, and we'll have a switch and an outlet. What I did with this, one of the ears is broken off and I didn't notice it when I bought it. So I broke them all off and screwed it through the back. I'm sure that somebody will complain about the waterproof integrity, but I'm gonna go ahead and do the same with this box because the ears are right on the edge and they have to really screw it in at an angle. So I'm gonna break those off and then we'll just screw it through the back up there. They had no 3/4 boxes, so we're gonna have to do a 1-inch box and put a bushing in it to 3/4. Of course, they put the barcode sticker right where you can't get it off. You gotta hold that for a second so it doesn't push out and nobody gets their panties in a wad in the comments. All right, so now I can glue that and screw that back to where I had it screwed on before, which should be about right.
So the next day, I have all the conduit run, my box and ceiling for future use, and it comes down the wall, and I'm gonna go ahead and pull two of each color in. I have various scraps of wire. So I measured off about 25 feet, and I've already pulled off and cut a white, a black, and a green. And I'll hopefully have enough left on these spools to pull the other 25 feet in. So I'll get this set up, tape it all together, and I should be able to push it through and then make all the corners. We'll see. Look out, Coop. Now for plan C, it involved me going and finding my fish tape. I'm gonna fish this tape down through there and pull at least this section with the tape. Success on that portion anyway. So now that we've made it this far, one of my blacks is not going to be long enough to pull all the way to the bottom. So I'm going to try to figure out which one's which, and we'll start making joints here. I'm going to cut all this apart and pull each one individually to get all my slack out further down the line. This is the box up in the ceiling. I'm just going to leave a little excess in there and not cut anything. That way, when I decide what I'm going to do up here, if I need to, I've got some slack. And for right now, I'll just put a blank cover in there and leave it like it is. So here's my plan. I will put two duplex receptacles in that box. Then down in this box will be a switched outlet in another duplex receptacle. So this one will be hot all the time. This one will switch one of the receptacles I'm gonna put out there. So then I can tie lights into that, and you can come out here and flip the switch and you'll have light. I have all the wire pulled in. First receptacle, pretty straightforward. We're just gonna pick a neutral and pick a hot and ground it and wire that in. So we're gonna cut this back to get it wire a little more manageable. The silver screws are the neutral, and this one we can pick any hole, it doesn't matter because they're jumped together. So it'll power both outlets from either one of these because of this bar in the center. So let's put it in that one. And then the hot wire, same deal. Problem with using stranded wire is on like the ground connection, the wire likes to push out. So while I'm here, I'm going to go ahead, pull that ground off. And put a fork terminal on it. That from pulling off. That'll still fit in the box. Okay. So I decided I'll go ahead and strip another black and another and the neutral and just run off this outlet down to the outlet in the bottom. I'm gonna go ahead and double up this ground wire down here, and then I'll have a ground down here that I can run over to the switch as well as the outlet. So there'll be a light switch in there with a cover, and the light switch just gets a ground and a hot in and a hot out. So I'm gonna have to run another black wire down here. This black is 10 gauge wire, which is all I had left in black stranded, and I cannot make it stay under these screws, or the way there's a little bump on there, the fork won't go on very well. So I'm gonna pull this stranded out. Had some scraps of Romex. I'll probably pull the red and the black out of this one, and I'll just use this last little run right here will be solid wire, which will work fine. I took the solid wire and pushed it up through the pipe, which is pretty easy because it's a straight shot. Now let's bend over some hooks on here. And it doesn't matter which terminal, which wire goes on, it's just a switch. Made my ground wire a little too short that I piggybacked over here, so I'm going to cut this. Strip it. And I'll just wire nut the ground together. So this is my hot wire coming in. It needs to actually go down to the switch and come back on the red wire. I forgot I had these little push-in wire terminals. I think they're probably better than wire nuts, as they won't come loose. You just push the wire in, it's got a little spring clamp that grips it. The downside is, I don't think you can take these apart. So you'd have to cut the wire if you wanted to make a change, whereas a wire nut, you could just untwist it. But we'll try them in this situation here, and they appear to work with both stranded and solid wire. I say that and it doesn't want to go in. There, finally. I also put one on the ground, so all three of these grounds can hook together. There. Now, the red wire can attach here. Alright, now everything's hooked up. All this should shove back in here.
So now we can connect every, obviously this is off. We can connect everything. In this case, it's color for color. Good idea to tug on a little bit too to make sure that they made a good connection and one of the small wires didn't try to push out as you twisted it. Which everything appears to be okay. Okay. We can go ahead and tape these two just to keep any corrosion out of them. Likely doesn't matter. Now that everything's connected, we can do some basic tests to make sure we don't have anything screwed up. So, have the meter set on resistance. We can put black lead in the ground, and we should be able, on the hot side, read no continuity, open. Over here on the neutral, we should read about no resistance, which we do, like 1 ohm. So it shows it's not grounded. So in the garage, in the panel here, there were two single pole 15 amp breakers that looked like that, except they were 15s. To free up space, I took them out and put what we call a piggyback or a tandem breaker in there. So that freed up a slot, and this is where I installed this GFCI outlet that goes out to where we were just in the pavilion. So it's all connected in the panel. I didn't show that because I'm pretty sure I'll get a bunch of negative comments about that, probably this whole operation, but in theory, I should be able to turn this breaker on and it should hold, which it did. So we should have 120-ish volts out there right now. Also, while I was going to the trouble of getting the wire through the panel, I had put this sub panel in a couple years ago when we redid our kitchen to make, since we had a separate cooktop and oven, I went ahead and put another breaker in, and I'm going to install a 220-volt outlet for welding purposes right here. You can check it, you can switch to voltage. Between
hot in the neutral. 119.7 or 120 volts. All right, I think that was a success.
So to recap all this, we trenched wire all the way out here through the lawn. Also coaxial cable, run that up. Ran it across the ceiling in here. Set a box up there for future additions such as ceiling fans, etc. Set a box up here. And a switch in a separate receptacle. And let's see if the lights come on. So this switch, or this outlet, is controlled by the switch. Then we strung up some Harbor Freight lights around onto the switch. So anyway, that'll pretty much end this whole series. The reason I set that outlet box up there is somewhere in this vicinity is gonna be a television, but we'll save that for another day. So any of you doing this at home, you're probably gonna be about $400 in material. The wire running this far from the house had to be that number 6 wire, but you notice we didn't have any voltage drop. We had 120 volts out here, so the voltage drop was negligible. Ended up being like 150 feet. If it's less distance, you could conceivably get away with smaller wire. There's not gonna be a lot of load out here. But based on that distance and going to all that trouble, I went ahead and ran that larger wire in a 20 amp circuit and installed it on a GFCI breaker. That GFCI breaker by itself is like $50. Anyway, thanks for watching. We'll see you soon.